Exactly. First quarter one and two in a very short span of 2.5 months. Even Ministry of Education's innovation cell has merged few activities of quarter one and quarter two and extended time to upload reports latest by 31st January of 2021. So a change has been made in quarter two activities, and this change has been also introduced due to the fact that it was not known beforehand that we will have winter vacations or not. So we had winter vacations, so we have opted for internship data, and we have floated one form among students for collecting internship data. And I request all students and faculty members to help in spreading information about internship data and help in getting that collected. Lectures on entrepreneurship have been shifted to quarter three, and there is information about quarter one activities. All have been successfully conducted. Quarter two activities, one activity has been replaced with the internship activity, and in quarter three, the first activity we are conducting today, IIC Council meeting review of quarter two progress and planning of quarter three. So since it's not possible to arrange offline meetings, so generally I plan beforehand what we will do in the next quarter, but still suggestions are invited from all members if we can do something else. Like first activity is mandatory activity, and then there is list of another activities which can be undertaken in this quarter. Already I have talked to Dr. Manika Kohli about workshop on business model canvas and competition to invite innovative business models from students. She will most probably conduct this activity in the last week of January or in the first week of February. And besides this, we had conducted idea competition in quarter two, and now our students should prepare prototype for those ideas, and for that we will arrange one workshop on prototype, process design and development. And we are in talk with the Scorewell team, a company who arranges such competitions. Then there is a session on how to plan for startup, legal and ethical steps. With this, we are in touch with Mr. Ekant Agarwal, who is the CEO of one startup. And then there is orientation session for all students by innovation ambassadors, and now entrepreneurship ambassador and Dr. Nitu will also handle one lecture over it. And I'm also very thankful to Dr. Vanna. She has also volunteered to conduct one session on a topic of her choice. And these are the activities which are to be conducted by conducted according to the IIC calendar. Beside this, we are to conduct self-driven activities and MIC activities. For self-driven activities, I always suggest all the department government is also arranging different type of events, hackathons, leadership talks, etc., which we float in our groups as and when we are informed. So recently, government has announced the toy hackathon, you can say, and Dr. Neetu is also providing information to various groups about this toycathon, and now she will give the basic guidelines about how to go about it. Beside this, there is one more information about Center for Innovation and Biodesign, CBIOD, PGI, MER, Chandigarh. They are inviting applications for a short-term attachment program. It is an initiative of Indian Council of Medical Research to promote research, innovation, and entrepreneurship in Indian healthcare system. Looking for students, the interested members to coordinate with me on my personal WhatsApp so that we can provide this data to them. They will give guidance for these mentioned technologies like innovation in basic sciences, Internet of Medical Things, IoMT, machine learning, artificial intelligence, chatbots, cloud and virtualization in medical services, ethics and social values, blockchain, data science, big data, augmented reality, virtual reality, GIS, GPS, LBS, robotics and automation, human computer interface, enterprise and business, cyber information, data security. So this is there is a long list of topics, but they will assign according to their choice. If one is really willing, only then one should give the name. If one has the time to devote, because they ask for many hours to devote on such programs. So I want volunteers who are really motivated. Then the report formatting. March, we will arrange another meeting for reviewing quarter three activities and planning of quarter four activities. And this, and you can get information from mic.gov.in. Then there is a Smart India Hackathon also. And it is just for the information of all the participants that we are also arranging internal hackathon on software hackathon, you can see. And right at this time, it is being organized and it will be for 3 days. Students are working on software problems and the selected students will be participating further into this event. This is the list of quarter four activities. If any innovation investor feels that one can conduct any activity, like there is session on angel investment, VC funding opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs, lean startup and minimum viable product incubation, prototype validation. If any of our innovation investor feels that they are confident enough to handle this session, please inform me. Thank you. And now the control is over to Dr. Neetu. She will guide you people about, or she will elaborate on toy hackathon. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. So now I'm going to share with you all guidelines for Toykathon 2021. So Toykathon 2021 is an initiative under Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan and has been conceived to challenge India's innovative minds to conceptualize novel toys and games based on Indian civilization, history, culture, and mythology. So I will be sharing the screen to give you more information regarding this. So this is the website toykathon.mic.gov.in. And the whole information is available on this site. And first of all, you need to go to this About tab. Under this, you will get all the information and the focus areas of this Toykathon 2021. And after this, some challenges are given, some problem statements are given here related to different topics. So social and human values, learning, education, schooling, Indian culture, related to environment, Divyang. So out of this, the students can choose any of the themes. Suppose you click on the problem statements on environment. So there are many statements given here. So you can go through the statements and can design the toy or game based on these statements. And for this, first of all, you need to register. So if you go to this registration tab, there are three categories given, track 1, 2, and 3. So our higher educational institutional students, they are eligible to register under track 2. So if you click here, you will go to the this field. And here you have to enter your details, name, email ID, mobile number, all the details, and then proceed for registration. So once you are done with this registration, you will be given the credentials and you will be able to log in. So suppose I have registered here, so I'm going to log in with my credentials. Now this thing will be available. We have to enter our team. We have to create our team and enter the details of the team. So a team can have a minimum of one team leader and maximum there can be 5 members in the team. The whole information is here. So you need to have some mentors also. So teachers can act as mentors and maximum number of mentors in a team is 2. So maximum cap of team members in a team is 5. So there will be one team leader and then team members and mentors. So including all these, there can be maximum of 6 members in a team. And you need to enter the details of all the team members by clicking on these tabs. So here you can create and manage your team, enter the details of your mentors also. And this way you will be able to register. And after this thing is complete, you have to submit your idea in the form of PPT. And the sample for idea PPT is given here. So this is the sample for idea PPT. So you have to enter the details like your idea title and you have to give a tagline for your idea. So tagline should be unique, should specify your idea. And then you have to give the overview of idea. How is it creative and attracting? What is your approach towards the idea development? So you have to be specific about your approach and the flow of your development and give the points here. And you have to mention whether you are going to design a physical toy or digital toy along with all the themes and how your toy is going to be different from the existing toys. And does your toy reflect Indian culture, ethos, Ayurveda, diversity, or psychology? So you have to mention all these details in this PPT. And now you have to provide some creative images or videos related to your product idea. So all the things should be attractive And last slide is of your team profile, objective, and then team details. And you need not add any other slides. So if you add more slides, you may be disqualified. So their requirement is that you have to mention the things in these 5 slides only. So if you add any other slide, then you will be disqualified. And the whole process is given under How It Works tab. So the theme was launched on 5th of January and registrations are open till 20th January. So we have 2 days left for completing the registration and idea submission process. And then scrutiny will be done. So first phase of scrutiny will be online. So ideas will be scrutinized online and the process will continue till 8th of February. And after which the results will be declared. So shortlisted teams will be declared on 12th of February. And then they will have to present their ideas offline in physical mode on 23rd February. But in the time period between 12th February and 23rd February, the people from this Ministry of Education and Innovation Cell, they will be mentoring the students. So they will provide whole support and they will give you mentoring, all support required for the prototyping of that idea. So finally, whatever you achieve and whatever you design, you will be allowed to represent that in the toy fair. So after the grand finale results are out, you will be given the prize money. There are prizes worth rupees 50 lakhs. So there is a huge prize money involved. And then selected ideas, they will be presented online in the toy fair and the date will be declared later on. So this is all about this Toycathon. And if you have any doubts, you can approach me or Dr. Indu Arora for more clarifications. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Neetu. I'm also thankful to Madam Principal. She has joined the meeting, I think. With this, I also take immense pleasure in sharing that Dr. Purnima and Madam Disha, who are our innovation ambassadors, they have delivered their sessions on team who are giving their wholehearted support to our various activities. And with this, I submit that we should take the activities for the next quarter with the same zeal and motivation. And I request support from you, from all of you. Thank you very much.
Ma'am, can we have a group photograph now?
Yes, yes. And attendance, all are requested to mark the attendance also.
All turn on your videos, please. Link has been posted and I'm posting it again. Link has been posted again. Thank you, ma'am. I've taken the photo.
So, thank you, everyone. Can we leave Dr. Neetu now?
Yeah, sure, ma'am. I've taken the
photo. Thank you, everyone, for attending this meet. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.